Our set, look at it, eh? We've got all Christmassy. How about that? And as a lot of you woke up to fog this morning, we've added a little bit of, but a little bit too much fog, to be fair, of ourselves.
Yes, we have. Now, joining us tonight are two beacons of elegance, dignity and grace for women everywhere.
Oh, are you okay?
Yeah. He stopped over last night, Alan. He was going to sleep in the spare bedroom, but... one thing led to another, and we shared the same bed.
Okay.
It's Anne Reed and Marinda Hart. The fog is clear, so we can see you now.
Yes. Brilliant at the top of the show. Hilarious. Marinda, what's more embarrassing, do you think? Getting soaked by a fountain or talking to your mum about your love life?
Oh, probably, and weirdly, the latter.
I think so too.
Yeah.
I'd run with you on that.
I'd always rather be soaked by a fountain. Talk to my mum about anything, maybe.
Yes.
Right, yeah. Well, speaking of which, and there is this survey out today. There is a survey out today that suggests, we don't want to go on about your age too much here, but that over 65-year-olds are concerned about what younger members of their family think if they do strike up a relationship.
I don't care. I'll do what I want to.
Yes.
I don't think my son would mind at all.
No.
I mean, I couldn't possibly be bothered, but I like...
I think
all that ironing shirts. I mean, it's all right, you know, somebody to go out with, but I don't want to have to cook for somebody. I don't want to have to consult somebody every day about, are we going to do this?
High five me, sister.
There we go.
High five me, Amory. Don't leave me hanging. Thank you.
In a moment, we're going to be honouring Marinda with some impressions of her.
Yes, but we are. Don't panic, it's all right. But Anne, so you don't feel left out, we've also got a clip of you kissing James Bond, effectively. Very
all
nice.
All done that.
Yeah, I know.
But first...
No, you haven't.
No, I haven't.
We so wish we had them. Yes. Now, first of all, we'd like to say hello to this person. Now, that's Jessica there. Hello, Jessica.
Hello.
Now, Jessica, before we explain why you're celebrating today, just let us all know why it is such a special date today.
Well, it's the 12th day of the 12th month, 2012, and it's my birthday.
Yay! Hang on. Jessica, how old are you?
I'm 12 today.
Yay!
Now, have you had lots of lovely presents, Jessica?
Yes.
What?
I've got a mobile phone, toiletries, makeup, clothes, and some money.
Good. All the girly essentials. But I think your mum has an extra present for you.
Yeah.
Is mum around to bring it in?
Yeah.
Here she comes. Here she comes.
Cake. You can't see it very well, but it's a one-shot cake. There we go. Isn't that lovely?
You can blow out the candles and make a wish, Jessica, if you'd like.
Right.
There you go.
Yay!
Yay. Yay. Happy returns. Have a very, very happy birthday. Isn't that wonderful?
Yes, it is. Now then, we'd like to set ourselves the challenge to find another 11 people who happen to be 12 today, on the 12th of the 12th of the 12th. So if you're celebrating, email us a picture and we'll wish you a happy birthday a little bit later on.
It's my grandson's birthday.
Is it?
How old is he?
24.
Oh,
well, that's double. It's nearly there, I see.
There we are, we're thirds anyway. First, there was the mis-selling of endowment mortgages. Then came dodgy PPI policies, and now, Marinda, the CPP scandal.
Yeah, now, Marinda, last time you were on, and I quote, you said the following. I don't want to let womankind down when people start talking about ISAs and derivatives. I think they're talking about biscuits, actually.
Yeah.
So, here you are, we've got you some.
Derivatives.
Feel free to dunk them, do
it in
the VT.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Have a look at this. Enjoy nibbling while you watch the film.
Thank you.
You may never have heard of them, but for 6 years, Card Protection Plan Limited sold insurance against ID fraud and the loss of...
It may well be a case of belt and braces, because what CPP have done with a lot of people is effectively sold them a very expensive pair of braces when they're already wearing a belt, you know. The fact is, They have missold an awful lot of policies, and if you have been missold a policy, Anne, you will get an email in January.
I can't remember the name of it, but I know I've got something. Anyway, go on.
Well, in January, if something happens, you'll get an email saying that you can claim, and then it could be a few hundred quid, or maybe even more, but you'll find that soon.
So if people like Anne there, people are dropping things over there, if people like Anne think they have been missold ID protection and credit card insurance, how can they prove it? Because it's very difficult, isn't it?
It is very difficult, but there are three things. Try and remember what happened in the phone call. If you were put under pressure, if you were quoted things like, one in five people have been the victim of ID fraud, that's a massive exaggeration, so that is a key clue that you might have been missold. And crucially, if you've put in a claim and it gets turned down by CPP, you can say to them, I want a recording of that phone call, but it may cost you between 5 and 10 quid. So basically, if you've been put under pressure or quoted statistics, you might have a case.
There you are, Anne. We'll just wait.
I'm not sure it's the same thing, but...
Wait until January, you might get an email.
Worth checking.
But if people are, you know, shopping around for insurance, what should they keep their eyes open for?
Well, I mean, it's interesting, this thing about being already covered. I mean, I recently wanted to take out holiday insurance, and I checked on my bank statements and realised I already had holiday insurance as a kind of bolt-on to my bank statement, so I didn't need it. Also, there are these family heirloom things. You're really paying attention, aren't you?
There
are these family heirloom things where people say, oh, should I pay a grand to have my grandmother's jewellery insured? The fact is, it's probably irreplaceable anyway, so why spend all that money insuring something that's irreplaceable anyway? So think if you really need it. Also, this is, it's a bit boring, but always shop around. I recently was quoted £1,000 for house insurance, went online and got a quote for 200 quid. The difference can be that much.
You do worry, though, don't you, with all the computers and stuff like that, that you think, if somebody's telling me there's ID fraud out there, yes, I'll have a bit of insurance for that.
Yes.
Or they could get all of my credit card details. Yes, I'll have insurance for that. It's very easy to go along.
Well, it's a massive industry. I mean, this company, CPP, in the report, they made £354 million gross profits selling these insurance policies. And as I say, a lot of people already had the belt, so they didn't need the braces, you know.
Pointless, it's a...
Have we got time? I'd just like, what do you do about these people who ring you up all the time? You've had an accident, and I think, what accident?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I haven't recorded.
I'm fine, actually. Goodbye.
Whatever you do.
On your accident.
Yeah. Whatever you do. And do not reply.
No,
because what happens is if you reply, then they will sell your details onto someone, often for up to £7.50 a time, and you'll carry on getting calls. If you reply, they know you're, in inverted commas, live, and so will continue plaguing you.
All the time.
Yeah, thank you. Well, there you are. Good advice, Jonathan. Thank you very much indeed.
Miranda,
one thing we do know that you're an expert of is physical comedy. I can't even say it. Physical comedy.
Oh, you're right.
Now, you could say that you've turned falling into a bit of an art form.
Oh. I am a smooth operator. Mr. Brand has swallowed me up.
So, Miranda, standing by are three students from the very same drama school that you trained, and each will attempt to recreate a Miranda fall from a past episode.
Yes. So, first up, we have Ben. Hello, Ben.
Hi.
Now then, this is your Miranda fall. Take a look at this.
Doesn't mean I can't be feminine. Look at that. Yeah, working it. It's all about the recovery, isn't it?
This is all about the recovery, isn't it? This is Ben, obviously, because of health and safety, he's fully helmeted up and he's wearing a boiler suit. Ben, good luck with this. Off you go.
Thank you.
Oh, there's the first bit.
Yeah,
going
good.
Well. Yeah.
It's all about the recovery, isn't it?
Here it comes.
Yeah.
Yeah. We can have another look at that now while you give a little critique over it. Okay. Here we are. Okay, so there he goes.
Lovely. Oh, sort of quite male model to start with, wasn't it? I like the swishing of the coat, yeah. Because I can tell the viewers that I can see a crash mat here.
I had no crash mat, thank you.
Oh! That is
sorry, I meant to be critiquing him, not showing off.
Well, we'll
that to me.
We're going to have more a little bit later on, so well done, Ben.
Yeah. Anyway,
well done, Ben. Excellent.
Now, Anne, we do know that at your drama school, Rada, you've had a teacher.
Miss Phillips falling down classes were the most useful thing I learned.
No, you did not.
Yes, we did. We had to learn to fall. And the thing is that as you get old, I think I still can do it.
Oh, and how did... Well, don't do it maybe now.
No. But in a Victoria Wood show, Mr. Wright, when she did As Seen on TV, the very first one I ever did with her, somebody pulled a chair out and I had to fall on the floor. And it's... I mean, it was actually the editing that made it so funny. Because
right,
it still makes me laugh.
Yeah.
And I don't know how many... And I've had to fall down in a play at the National Theatre. And not too long ago, I can't remember how long, about 2 years maybe, I was in Shameless.
Okay.
And I said, and I had had a fight with somebody and that had to fall on the floor. And they said, well, get a stunt woman. And I said, no, I do my own falls. Wrong. And I went, and we fought and knocked me over. And I fell down, nearly knocked myself out on the bridge. And I thought, I think we're too old to do this.
Well, we might find a spare helmet, Anne, if you fancy. Because we've got the crash mat, obviously.
You
so you never know.
I can't believe you had classes of falling over, Rada.
Yes, we
that
did.
That is a scoop.
Very good. You have to relax, you know.
You do. You have to go all elastic. But I was never taught.
Oh, wow. You're just a natural, Marinda. Now, you must have done lots of falling over in the lead up to Christmas because you're on telly a lot, aren't you? You've got Call the Midwife, Christmas Day, 7:30. And then, we can't wait, the brand new series of Marinda kicks off on Boxing Day. Now, do you feel nervous?
Yeah, very nervous, actually. Yeah, because you spent sort of 7 months writing it and then we perform it and we do it in front of a live audience, so obviously we get some feedback, which is lovely, but still it's sort of letting go of your baby and thinking, well, what people are going to think? You don't want it to be on almost.
And will you watch it, both of them? Will you know it's on and just kind of, I don't know, play a board game or something?
I won't. Well, I'm not very good at sitting and watching myself. It's the only, I mean, it's a real privilege to be on telly at Christmas.
Yes.
You know, it's sort of...
Yeah.
Dream come true, really,
of course.
To be beauty one at Christmas, but it's slightly ruined Christmas telly for me. I'll just sit down and watch. No, I won't. That's me.
Well, seeing as you can't watch it, the whole episode, have a look at a little bit because honestly, it's really funny. Here it is.
What else can we look forward to in the new series?
I think she's wonderful.
Oh,
that means a lot coming from.
I do. Are you asking any of my friends? I'm a huge fan. Huge.
Stop it.
Oh no.
So yeah, just give us an idea of what Anne can look forward to in the new series.
Well, there's some kissing.
Oh, with Gary.
I'm not saying anything more than that, or who it might be, or there's. There's a couple of celebrity cameos, our first celebrity cameos. Ooh. That's exciting.
And can you give us a clue?
Well, we were trying to keep it secret, but it did get out.
Oh.
And Sir Gary Barlow is popping up.
Oh, it's lucky you.
I know.
So Miranda's got a new Gary in her life.
Oh, I'm tossing it like that.
Oh.
Yeah.
Very good,
But so that was exciting. And Raymond Blanc was in it. Oh, Raymond Blanc.
He's not working in the pub, is he?
No.
Okay.
It's kind of more of a sort of a general story arc this time. It feels a bit different. It's more character driven. There's a couple of new characters.
We're excited.
The first two episodes kind of set it up quite slowly and then we get into it.
So, it's quite monumental because it's going to be the last sitcom to be filmed in TC8 down the road in BBC.
Yeah. Well, it was. We finished it mid-October. And Studio 8 is like the famous sitcom studio. And I had a little weep actually when it finished because I felt like it's all my.
But it's true. I mean,
it's
so many memories.
No, but it's true.
You can feel it, can't you?
Yeah, and also because it was my dream to get into comedy since I can remember. So I couldn't believe I was in that studio anyway, let alone the last one. And all my heroes in there, Morecambe Wise, Two Ronnies, your Ab Fab was there. To the Man of Bourne, Blackadder. I mean, just.
All the greats.
All the greats. It was amazing.
But you're not on your own in the weeping stakes, are you?